More toll plazas along the North Luzon Expressway and the Subic-Clark-Tarlac Expressway are now going cashless. This as the fifth batch for the dry run of contactless toll collection gets underway. Among those added in this batch's dry run are the San Simon Southbound Exit, Porac Toll Plaza, Florida Blanca Toll Plaza, and the Balintawak Toll Plaza. Additional traffic personnel were deployed to facilitate the installation of RFID stickers and electronic toll collection system used for the automatic toll fee payment.
Pwede doon mismo sa lane po, ano, no? Mabilis lang naman po yung pagkakatip. May isang minuto lang po yung ano. So, prior doon sa pila, meron na rin po itong form na binibigay, no?
At least 80% of toll gates in the North Luzon Expressway have been implementing cashless toll collection. Meanwhile, those passing through SCTEX will see additional toll fees ranging from 25 pesos to as much as 191 pesos starting October 17 or Tuesday. Some transport groups pushing through with today's scheduled strike to protest the jeepney phase-out and the alleged corruption within the LTFRB. Manibela President Mar Valbuena says they canceled a dialogue with Malacañang officials on Sunday. Let's now get an update on the ground from our correspondent Liza Aquino, who joins us live from Commonwealth Avenue in Quezon City. Liza, hi. Are you seeing a lot of stranded passengers there this morning?
Mimi, I'm currently here in Filcoa in Commonwealth Avenue in Quezon City. And as of now, it's still business as usual in the area. We can still see a lot of PUV vehicles, particularly the jeepneys over here servicing our passengers during the morning rush hour. I also received an update from the local government unit in Caloocan and in Manila, and as of now, they have not reported any stranded passengers in one of their major thoroughfares in their respective cities. Manibela President Mar Valbuena initially announced that they will push through with a scheduled strike today protesting the public utility vehicle modernization program after certain officials allegedly blocked the negotiation meeting at Malacañang. He added that at least 500 routes out of the total 785 routes in Metro Manila will join the transport strike. Meanwhile, different local government units are ready to deploy additional buses and vehicles to areas which will be affected by the said strike. Some local governments in Metro Manila, Mimi, also announced that in-person classes will not be suspended in their respective cities. Interior Secretary Benver Avalos also gave assurance that there will be no transport paralysis today as 95% of transport groups will continue to operate.
Just the same, ang buong pamahalaan po ay naghanda muli para po kung sakaling magkaroon nga po ng disruption sa pampublikong transportasyon, tayo po ay nakahanda. Meron na po tayo mga naka-preposition na mga sasakyan para po kung sakaling meron po tayong mga kababayan na ma-stranded ay matugunan po natin at mabigyan po natin sila ng masasakyan.
As far as we are concerned, there is no result. Number one, 95% ng lahat ng transport group ay kasama natin at sila po ay hindi dadalo. Number two, nakaagapay ang kapulisyahan. Number three, may magandang plano rito. Ang Central Monitoring Team will be MMDA. I-monitor niya lahat ng LGUs in Metro Manila.
Mimi, aside from conducting a transport strike today, Manibela is also set to hold protests in different LTFRB regional offices across the country this morning. That's the latest here on Commonwealth Avenue. Mimi, back to you.
Thank you very much for that update. Liza Aquino there joining us from Quezon City. The Philippine Transportation Department stands firm it will continue the much-contested public utility vehicle modernization program despite the protests. By December 31 of this year, drivers and operators should have already formed an association or a cooperative which should have been consolidated. The DOTR says the consolidation is already at 70%. The agency also clarifies the phase-out of old jeepneys will not be outright.
Tuloy-tuloy po yung pagkoconsolidate, pagbubuo ng either corporation po or cooperative for them to reach that deadline. After that, doon pa lang po papasok yung modernization. It does not mean that by January 2024, modern na po tayo lahat. It will still take a few more years para mag-modern. So yung PUVMP, programa ng gobyerno, tuloy-tuloy na po ito. Not only tuloy-tuloy na, but makakatulong na malaki sa ating mga mananakay at sa ating mga transportation corporations at cooperative. So this is a very good day, a good sign for the program to continue pa.
Local pump prices are set to see mixed movements this week. Diesel and kerosene will be slashed by 95 centavos per liter, while gasoline prices are going up by 55 centavos per liter. This will take effect by Tuesday, October 17th. Here's some interesting news for job seekers. A chat-first career platform called Boss Job is utilizing artificial intelligence to help career hunters find jobs. The platform uses artificial intelligence to create profiles and generate instant resumes and even connect them with hiring managers. The technology was tested during a one-day job fair over the weekend that involved 70 local companies across various industries.
The job seekers can actually just provide the keywords of their previous work experiences, internship experiences, or even experiences from like their own entrepreneurial projects or like extracurricular activities. So based from those keywords, we can help them generate the resume in just a matter of seconds. We have a skill-based matching function, which means that depending on like what their experiences are, we can actually identify what are their skill sets and expertise. And based on these skill sets and expertise, we can better provide these talents to the employers, to the companies that who's actually looking for these types of skill sets to better, I would say, like better match them or even actually streamline the job seeking experience for the talents.
The finance department has shared that Japanese banks have expressed strong interest in advancing investments in the Philippines, renewable energy, sustainable technology, infrastructure, fixed income instruments in a series of meetings with the Finance Secretary Benjamin Jokno on the sidelines of the 2023 annual World Bank IMF meetings in Morocco. If you're wondering why we don't have the chat with Ben usual embargoed stories, this is why, because the finance chief is in Morocco. Secretary Jokno shared that representatives from the Japan Bank for International Cooperations, Mizuho Securities, Nomura Holdings at the Philippines, renewing focus on a just transition to renewable energy, opportunities for public-private partnerships, and investments in the country's infrastructure flagship projects and growing market for bonds and sustainable finance instruments. The meetings in Marrakech serve to sustain conversations with partners in the Japanese financial sector following the president's Tokyo visit last February and the recent high-level infrastructure meeting in Japan that happened just this August.